I'm Claudia, I'm 26 years old and I come from Italy. I'm an HDYO ambassador and I help managing the HDYO Community Stories program. And today we are here with Ashley and Josh. So if you guys wanna start introducing yourselves.
Hello, I'm Joshua. I'm from Scotland and I'm 26 years old. I'm a part of the HDYO community as well, and I'm an executive manager and a child of inflation.
Hi, my name is Ashley. I'm 21 years old. And I'm from Iowa, or United States.
So, Josh, how are you impacted by HD?
My dad told me when I was 15 that he had it. And then afterwards, I got tested at 18. And then I found out I'd juvenile Huntington's disease at 19.
Thank you. And Ashley?
So my dad was diagnosed when I was a baby. So I grew up in the HD community. My dad passed away when I was 8 in 2010. He was 41, and then I was diagnosed 2 years ago with GHD.
So, Josh, before your diagnosis of GHD, did you ever heard about it?
No, because my dad was adopted as well, so we hadn't even heard of Huntington's in general.
And Ashley, did you know about it?
Yes, I knew of GHD, but I didn't know much about it. Like, I just like how things are different, symptoms and challenges. I just thought they got it sooner.
Okay, thank you. And Josh, how exactly did you discover that you have GHD?
Well, my mom and my worker, Pete, they both thought I was showing symptoms really early. So they decided to get me tested. And then when they did, they found out I had GHD.
Ashley?
So in high school, sorry, this is gonna get probably pretty long. So in high school, I was a cheerleader, and that's the thing I was most passionate about. I was committed to it seriously. My senior year, I started noticing some balancing issues, and I was also having lots of depression, anxiety, and OCD. So I used to get good grades in high school. I was in honor society. And then when I was in college, my grade dropped dramatically, like way low. And my depression, anxiety, and OCD just kept getting worse. And I failed a class, which I've never failed before in my life. So that was really stressing me out. So I ended up with a Dr. Polis at the University of Iowa, which is a center of excellence for Huntington's disease, 2 hours away from me, so I'm fortunate for that. And so I was, what's it called? Oh yeah, a genetic test was done on me and confirmed the diagnosis.
Thank you. And Ashley, when you got this diagnosis, what were your first thoughts and feelings?
When I was diagnosed, I started literally bawling my eyes out. I was just thinking to myself, how long do I have? How will people react? How will my family respond when I tell them? I was scared. I felt alone. And I felt like my life was no longer mine. I felt hopeless or helpless.
I'm sorry to hear that. And Josh, when you got that diagnosis, not knowing what GHD was, how did you feel?
I was really scared and confused, but I was really depressed because I didn't know what was going to happen. Because I thought I was going to have like a long life, and then I got told I had Huntington's disease, so I'd get a short life. And then I got told I do know Huntington's disease, so I'd get an even shorter life. So I was really depressed, and I was also kind of the same time.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for sharing that. And about your daily life, how has GHD affected that and your relationship with others.
So relationships have been very hard for me. I had this best friend that I was friends with for over 6 years. She got engaged last October, and she invited me to be in her bridesmaid. And I already told her some problems I would have at her wedding if, whatever. So she said it was fine and she'd accommodate me. So then, like, some months later, I got a text message from her saying that she wasn't comfortable with me being a bridesmaid because of my disease. And she's concerned of how I'd behave. Like, I don't know how to react. I was completely heartbroken and just started crying. She hurt me beyond belief. She didn't even have the decency to talk to me about her concerns. She just texted it to me, didn't call. I had an aunt, oh yes, didn't call or anything. I also had an aunt who used to be a huge part of my life, but now she doesn't do anything with me. I've literally begged her to be in my life, but she's not. I have trouble making new friends because they just see the disease and not me. They don't take the time to get to know me. On the positive side, my HD community has been awesome, and I've had many new friends who I consider to be my family.
Thank you, Ashley. I'm really sorry that that happened to you, and basically it's why we're doing this, to just spread information so that people don't just see the disease but try to understand that we're a lot more and not just that. And really, I'm really sorry that happened to you.
Yeah, I'm
And
really sorry as hell.
Josh, did you how were the biggest challenges that you experienced?
Well, for me, I had it was much luckier because for me, all my friends I've had since primary and high school and college, none of them have left me. But I used to be really bad for anger. So whenever I had outbursts, all my friends would give me time to leave me alone. But once I said sorry, they'd always come back to me. But my daily life, I've been about struggling as hell because I've got really shaky hands. So sometimes I drop stuff or need my mom to open stuff for me because I can't open stuff myself.
So thank you, really, really thank you. And about support, had you had difficulty finding appropriate medical care and support? Did doctors knew what JHD was?
So as I told before, I fortunately live 2 hours away from the University of Iowa Center of Excellence. My psychologist, Dr. Napolis, is amazing, as well as my team at the university. My psychiatrist, neurologist, pharmacist, and my physical therapist.
Great. So you have support, and that's great. And Josh, what about you?
Well, for me, I've been really lucky because my daughter didn't know about it before meeting me, but she researched it so that she could know about everything to do with GHD and Huntington's disease. And I've been really lucky as hell because I got great support groups like HDYO and SHA. I'm always looked after.
That's great that she took the time to research
Yeah.
that and try to be prepared.
Understand. Yeah.
Yeah. And about research and therapies, Josh, what are your hopes for the future regarding HD?
I'm hoping we get a cure and or at least someone. Because right now, because it's due now, we've got really fast. We don't have as much time, so I'm hoping we get more time.
Ashley, what about
Sorry.
you? What are your hopes when you think about research and therapies for JHD?
Oh, okay. Here. I found it. So since I'm an adult, I can consent to trials, but they do not have any trials for JHD symptoms. It sucks. Why can't I participate in them when I am an adult? It frustrates me.
Yeah, that's too bad, really. And about speaking about support, how do you involve in this journey with the disease, your family, your friends, people around you? Josh, what about you?
Well, for me, again, I've been really lucky because all my friends and family, I always tell them everything that's happening to me. Like, they all know about this injury because they're all really close and stuff.
Yeah, I remember you wearing a t-shirt with I have JHD. Asked me about it at
Yeah.
Congress, and I totally loved that.
Yeah.
And Ashley, how about you?
Well, I don't really have friends. So it's mostly my parents. Since I can't drive, mom takes me everywhere. She take tries to take me as many places that I want to go. I don't have many friends because of my disease. People in my life have left me. If they don't want to be during the bad, then they're not going to be there for my good.
And that's really, really bad. And just about it, Ashley, what do you wish that people knew more about JHD?
How much of a struggle it is to get up every day not knowing what's going to happen or which body part is going to hurt today. It's mostly my back and leg pain, and every day I can feel myself succumbing to this disease. Sorry. My memory has gotten so much worse and my body pain is awful. It's hard for me to walk. I love multitasking, but with JHD, it's almost impossible to do two things at once. I am not an angry person, but with JHD, I'm constantly hitting myself, yelling and screaming at my mom, and throwing things.
What do you wish that people knew more about JHD?
It's not easy because a lot of people seem to think it's going to get cured or it's going to go away, but it's not going away. It's still here. It's stuck with us.
And I think that you both have support, as you said, but what are the resources of organizations that you found helpful in managing this condition? Ashley?
So I would definitely say Help for HD and HDYO have been extremely amazing to me. I feel like I can just be myself and no one will judge me because they know what you're going through. I feel loved by people in these organizations. Honestly, my best times are at these events.
Great. And Josh, what about you?
Like I said before, HDYO and CHA are my main support network because they've helped me so much stuff. Like, I didn't know how much money I could get from being disabled or juvenile, but what someone from CHA revealed how much I can get. So now I get a load of money.
Oh, yeah. I'll just clarify that CHA is the Scottish
Oh,
Huntington Association, so that.
yeah. Scottish Huntington's
Those who doesn't know,
Association.
and that's great. Really, really, this support. I have this support myself, so I know how incredible it really is. And about moments, Josh, what's been one of the toughest moments that you've faced because of JHD, and how did you overcome it?
Well, sometimes my family doesn't understand because sometimes they would say stuff like, "Oh, you'll get better, don't worry, you'll get better one day," or something like that. Or because they're Christians, they'll say, "I'll pay for you, make it go away," and stuff like that. But for me, it's not going to make me go away. So I have to tell them and inform them it's not going away. I'll tell you this, I'm going to die from it. No
Thank you. Thank you for
problem.
sharing. And Ashley, what about you?
Well, when I walk slowly and others behind me will get right up behind me and start to walk faster, trying to get me to move. And when I go to big events, I usually use my scooter and people just ignore me. I have my horn on my scooter and people just don't care about anyone but themselves. And it frustrates me a lot. I'm human too. You can clearly see me there. When I try to speak up to people, they just don't move or just don't listen. I'm tired of places that aren't very accessible. Accessible. Sorry.
No, don't worry. That's too bad. Really, really, I'm sorry about that. But despite this disease, what are actually the activities or interests that bring you joy? Your hobbies, stuff that you love doing?
Love watching movies and play with my dogs. I got four of them.
Oh.
I love to thrift and travel. I love to drink with my family. I like to dance and listen to music.
Great. And Josh, what are your hobbies and
I
things that
also
bring
love
you?
Yeah, I also love dancing. Like, I love going to Dance 100, which is a Scottish Huntington event where you end up, you dance for 6 hours to 100 songs. You don't need to do it, but I like doing it. Yeah, but that's the great thing for me. And also, like, mostly, sorry, gaming and playing with the cats. Because I got 6 cats.
Oh yeah. And I remember you dancing at Congress like all night long.
I started that. And there was two chicken,
Amazing.
but I wasn't.
And Ashley, do you have any advice for those who are facing ADHD or those fa their families?
Probably just be patient with your loved one. They're doing their best and they need love and support. They might freak out and yell and scream at you, but that doesn't mean we don't love you any less.
That's really a great advice. And Josh, what about you?
Don't stop praying. Keep on going. Because I got told I had 5 years, but I'm still here now, I think 7 or 8 years later. So I'm being nods and you can too.
Thank you. And Josh, what goals do you have? How do you see yourself in the future?
Well, I used to, when I was younger, used to want to go on tour and sing and dance and raise money and awareness for Huntington's disease, and I still want to do that.
And I can totally picture you singing and dancing. Yeah, really. And Ashley, what about you?
I just live my life day by day. Some days I love to do stuff with people. I like meeting new people. I'm an extrovert, so I get my energy being around people. I try to tell people about HD because they usually don't know what's wrong with me.
That's great. And Ashley, what's one of the most positive things or experiences that you had relating to HD?
So I've met so many people who love and care for me. I have an all new family because of organizations like Help for HD and HDYO. I have an HD family who supports me through the ups and downs. We love each other and we grieve together. There is no one in this world who knows me better than Katie and Katrina from Help for HD. They are constantly loving me through bad days and good days.
That's really great. And Josh, what
For me,
about
as high as what's it called, the HDYO Congress, because that was amazing. I got to meet so many people. I was really informed. It was a great time. It brought a
Yeah,
lot of positivity to my life.
it was really shocking, yeah, to meet all those people. And Josh, is there anything else you would like to add or share about JHD?
Just keep fighting. Don't give up. You can make it as long as we have. You got us.
Great. Ashley, did you want to add anything?
I think that's it. Thank you.
No, thank you guys. Really, thank you for being here, for sharing your story. And we are like educating people right now so that we are not just some disease, but
Yeah.
we are people. So
Yeah.
really, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So thank you for watching HDYou Community Stories, where we share stories of people impacted by HD. Please know that at any time, if you need HDYO, they are here to support you. Find out more at hdyo.org.